During this course, you'll be producing four videos that you will submit. These videos will be submitted by uploading them to YouTube. You do not have to appear in the videos. These videos will help provide documentation of your cultural practices with plants. They'll be in four different areas: healing plants, food plants, plants and material culture, plants that we use to build things, construct things, plants we use as tools, plants we use as decoration. That'll be the third area. I'll introduce that at that time later in the course. And the fourth area will be plants used in ceremonial uses, plants of legends, stories, sacred plants, those sorts of things. These four videos will provide a way of documenting some of the plant knowledge of your culture, a way of preserving some of that knowledge, knowledge that's being gradually lost over the passing of the years. And so the first one will be on healing plants. And that's always an area that generates some discussion, because there's the question of, well, but healing plants, medicine plants, are sacred, secret knowledge. Well, there are such things, and those should be kept within the families and clans within which that medicine belongs. That's true. However, there's some things, like Osimum Tenui Florum, seen here, that everybody knows as being useful medicinally. Not just here in Micronesia, but it's used in many places around the world, both as food and medicine. But as a medicine plant, it's very useful in an herbal steam bath for clearing your sinuses from congestion. This isn't a secret. This is widely known. When I talk about healing plants, that's what I'm talking about. Plants that are known to be healing by a broad range of communities and cultures, what we call public healing knowledge, knowledge of a particular plant, such as a plant such as this one, used in Yap, occasionally to the outer islands, at least sometimes, to staunch bleeding. Whereas here on Pompeii, if someone has a cut, they're more likely to use this particular plant to staunch the bleeding. Again, a widely known remedy for a fairly common ailment. So that's what I'll be looking for in your healing plant video. It should be short. We're talking, it'll only be 2 to 3 minutes. And I'll do an example of it and show you how I put together my healing plant video. I'll do one for you to see. That will be posted as well. So you can see what I'm talking about. But I'm not talking about any private or secret knowledge. I'm talking about that common knowledge that is known by many, many people within the culture. It's simply publicly known. Banana trees, a very important medicine plant in the outer islands. I've been told by Pinglipis that it's one of their most important medicine plants. And there's other plants that are used for treating other things. Some of them may not be strictly healing, but it's known that the gel that comes from this particular ginger plant is very good for one's hair. And so it's used widely as a hair conditioner. And again, broadly known. So you'll be doing a short video explaining how the plant is used, share the name of the plant, one treatment, one single thing it treats, but share your local name of the plant, share your local name for the illness that it treats, and put that together. You'll probably have to edit your video together. In fact, I'll be recommending that you use a video editor. whether it's something like UCut or if you can get a hold of it InShot or anything else. Some of you have iOS, you may have iMovie. And using that editor to put together, you can put together still shots and video shots into a single movie. Here we have Kurkuma Longa. It's another ginger. Here on Pompe Kisinyong, another medicinal plant. Typically down here it is the base of the plant that is used to create in Koshai, Kaki Ang. And you can hear the word Ang in the Pompean word Kisinyong. Sometimes there's relationships between our words. So this is what your video will be about. A single plant gets used to treat something in a healing fashion. A medicinal plant. But a single plant for a single particular illness or condition. And again, keep it short. Just a couple minutes. It's fine. Show us the plant. Show us how you use that plant to treat a particular illness or condition or in some way in which it heals people. One other area that I would touch on, there are some illnesses that don't translate. That's okay. You don't have to try to translate them. Illnesses such as somaoeneni don't translate very well. It's incorrect to translate that as some kind of ghost sickness, because ghost is a culturally loaded word. It has particular meanings in English, and any does not have the same connotations in its native language. So I wouldn't try to translate it per se, but those are illnesses too. My culture treats hiccups as an illness. Hiccups are considered to be an illness that needs to be treated. Usually by, one way we try to do it is to scare the heck out of a baby, make it stop hiccuping. Now anybody who has grown up here in Pompeii knows that if you scare a baby, you can cause the baby to become sick. This is definitely not a healing treatment. But in my culture, we treat hiccups as an illness. In most of the cultures here, hiccups are seen as a sign that a baby is growing, and if they aren't hiccuping, they're not growing. And in fact, there's medicines in Koshai to help the baby grow if it's not hiccuping, to help it hiccup, actually. And in Pompeii, there's medicines like Guinium Piriamwe to help the child not become afraid of the hiccups themselves. Here's another one of our medicine plants, very effective at fungal infections, very effective at treating fungal infections, widely known across Micronesia, Shragito, Jugendkilenwai, I believe it might be called Erakak, and possibly in Chuuk. But again, a common medicinal plant, people are aware of it. It's not a secret that this plant will cure you of illnesses that we know as ringworm and other fungal skin infections, very effective. So that's what you'll be doing. You'll prepare and upload a video that will leave behind a record for the future of a particular plant, a particular use, something that will be there to record for future generations, that small piece of your culture. Because that's an important part of this course, to carry the culture forward to the next generation. Do you know the name of that plant that we're looking at? It grows here on Pompeii. Do you know its use? A lot of that is being lost. So part of this course is about documenting that knowledge, preserving some of that knowledge for future generations, that it might not be lost. Information that's important and useful to be conserved. So think about what you might want to do a film on. Take a look at mine. I did both a video and a look at how I put the video together, so you can see both, and then do the same. You will want to compress your video to 720p to try to get it uploaded. Keep it short, run it at 720p. I think you'll find success in this exercise. Let me know if you have questions.